This is CNN Breaking News.
We do begin with breaking news. We want to welcome our viewers in the United States and all around the world. You're watching New Day, and it has been a painful night of violence and protest in Minneapolis. At this hour, fires are still burning on the south side of Minneapolis after protesters took to the streets to demand justice for George Floyd, the unarmed, handcuffed black man who pleaded with a police officer to let him breathe as the officer pinned him to the pavement with a knee to his neck. The city's mayor is urging people to leave the area, and he has reportedly asked the governor to call in the National Guard.
The Minneapolis mayor also says he does not understand why the police officer responsible for Floyd's death has not been charged. Overnight, police did use tear gas to disperse the crowds. At least one man is dead this morning. The circumstances still under investigation. Police say he was shot and killed outside a pawn shop near the demonstrations. CNN's Omar Jimenez live on the scene. Omar, you've been up all night watching these developments. Tell us what's happening now.
Well, John, frankly, Minneapolis is waking up to parts of its city on fire, parts like where we are standing right now, basically across the street from the Minneapolis Police 3rd Precinct, which has really been the central location for these protests. Protests that, as you can see, devolved into riots and multiple structures on fire. You just, as we pan over, you see the smoke billowing across the entire south-southeast Minneapolis area here. And this, as smoldering and as on fire as it is, when we first got here, right before that or so, this was a two-story building. There was a whole other section that was completely engulfed in flames and then eventually collapsed. Now you go across the street from this building. You see how the police are set up in the middle of the, you see how police are set up in the middle of the road right here. They had formed a little bit of a roadblock to prevent people from going across the street into literally what was an active scene of fire this morning. And then across the street is the parking lot where you see some grocery stores that have been looted. And again, this is what happened as the protests began, largely peaceful in at least two locations across this city, and then devolved into riots. Now you go into the central reason that we are seeing these protests. It is for the death of George Floyd, but also how that death unfolded. We have seen that while the officers were fired pretty quickly, the four officers involved within 24 hours of this happening, the family says they want more than that. And that is a mentality that we have seen echoed throughout the protesters. We have seen the mayor of Minneapolis chime in on that as well, saying that these officers need to be charged, and at least the arresting one, he does not understand why that officer is not behind bars. We do know the investigation is still playing out at the FBI level, at the state level and beyond, trying to gather all the facts. But every minute that goes by without at least an announcement of either some charges or not, the people here grow restless. And again, the central point is how George Floyd went from, in a matter of minutes, pleading for help to what eventually became an eternal silence.
Earlier today, we'll show you some of the pictures of what went on. You know, there were flashbangs thrown by the police. There was tear gas. That was in reaction to water bottles being thrown at police, and then eventually firecrackers at the police precinct, as well as eventually folks throwing things and breaking the windows, some of the windows of the precinct. But police responded in force. They came out, flanked the entire side of their precinct, and you saw chaos just erupt. People were running. There was, you know, it looked like the same picture as I have covered protests around the world, the same picture that we saw, for example, in the early days in Ferguson, although there were not the military-style vehicles that were used in that particular protest. Instead, what you saw is protesters, for example, moving things like huge garbage cans into the way, police walking in a line trying to push people back, and that constant back and forth between police and protesters, a lot of the protesters with their hands up. That's just become, you know, the chant in the United States, be hands up, don't shoot. And so what you're seeing is absolute frustration, absolute angst and anguish and anger over this video. And this is just one in a string of things that has happened in the Minneapolis, St. Paul area. You know, they've had some other incidents where black men have been killed by officers. And this is just one in a string of that. But this video is so excruciating to watch. It is so painful to watch no matter, you know, sort of where you land on the spectrum of what you think happened, you actually see a man die right there in front of your face. And so there's been such an emotional reaction to this. You saw mothers, fathers, you saw grandparents out there today, as well as in some cases some children. And then later on in the evening, things changed. As night fell, I was outside watching as suddenly the flashbangs and the back and forth got very serious. We saw what appeared to be Molotov cocktails that were sort of sitting, and we were waiting to see what the protesters were going to do with those. The rest of the group of protesters are sort of standing back and having that conversation and yelling at police. And then suddenly a fire broke out. Fire broke out at the AutoZone, and it was engulfing the entire, you could see the smoke just billowing. That particular store is right across the street from the third precinct, the police precinct here in Minneapolis, where people had been protesting. On top of that, you saw people break into eventually a wine and spirit store, and suddenly, you know, a dozen people went in and started taking things out, looting that store, and then all hell broke loose, for lack of a better word, at the Target, where we saw people going in and just taking cartloads of things out of Target, putting that in their cars. It turned into a melee and a reaction that, you know, some people at the very beginning of this who were out there in the daytime, some elders who were out there in the daytime, African-American leaders, saying, please don't do this. Please don't let this deteriorate. Violence begets violence. But there is a way to go about this. But there are others who were saying, we are so angry, you can fix stores and you can repair windows, but you can't bring back this life. And this is their reaction to that. And you are still seeing that go on now. I mean, there is still smoke billowing. There are still firefighters trying to control that. There are still police out and protesters as well.